Oh yeah, so all right, everybody, we are 7 hours, seven,
9 hours in, 8 hours,
nine hours into our trip.
We lost count at three.
To Montana, and which means we're about one third of the way. We've been driving all day.
I've been driving for at least 17 hours just myself, and then Grayson was driving before that.
We are now in Kansas City.
Yep.
And this is what we get to check out right now.
Yeah, a nice little sunset.
Which looks fantastic.
Guys, I'm so happy for you to be here. This is awesome. I can't wait to do this.
Yeah. Man, this is a cold AC.
You
stink.
We're going to have better shots than anyone.
I hate you, Grayson.
Well, I'm glad you're comfortable.
Wow.
Very good.
Turn on the trap music and roll out the windows.
Alex is putting on some shoes.
Combat boots.
His feet were hurting from all the gear shifting from going barefoot on these BAA TVs. It's right. This is how we're transporting our beautiful, beautiful camera equipment that we've rented. It's absolutely fantastic. We got these ATVs here. A beautiful, very magnificent view. This is the one I'm using. This is very fun. And this. This is the view. I wake up to every morning out here in this Montana McAlister residence. Coming in from Bozeman. Looking good. Hey, Grayson's our cowboy.
Sup, dude?
It's gonna be working in the films for us, and also directing it and concept artist. Got off the trail again, went to do a lake shoot.
Yeah.
Got to see way too much more of Grayson than we wanted.
A lot of skin.
Alright. We,
Got the drone.
Came in the mail today.
That is a large box.
It is a large box, and I see why he said it was dirty.
Oh, man.
There's probably a case inside there. We can just take it out of the box.
So, yeah. But return labels. We got to stay on the box. Alright. Anyways, we're excited. We're going to be doing that. Right now, it's been an awesome day.
Covered in dust.
Absolutely just covered.
Covered.
This is how Matthew McConaughey felt in Interstellar. The dust! They got like dust shell shock.
It's crazy. Absolutely crazy. Just like this view. This view, again, I can't get over this view right now. It's just like, what the heck? That's just amazing. Most of this is this guy's land. He's got like 300-400 acres, something like that, right here, that you're looking at. It's crazy. All right, anyways. Shots of that later. So I was in this creek area, and there was this giant just pile of stuff. I slipped and fell backwards a little bit, caught myself with my left foot, but I just got so like ankle deep in a mixture between cow patty and just old creek water that's been stagnant for a while. It just feels gross. Anyway, so I washed my foot off in this cleaner creek right here. Woo. Make it soak to the bone. Just gotta get that clean. Woo. It's cold. Woo. Alright. Feels a lot better, a lot cleaner anyways. I'm soaked, but at least it ain't gonna stink. Stank bad. get back on that four wheeler.
Wait for me.
Woo! This is Magic Mike to Lupin Crew. I have cleaned the foot. I repeat, I have cleaned my foot. Coming your way.
Through. We're gonna make him young again. Looks back. St. Pierre's gone. Gonna ride up. We don't think we have to move anything, but we might bring out the Ronin again. I'm assuming. Or do you want to do it with something else?
What's the shot?
I think the tripod would be easier because I can do some serious focus racking, pulling with the tripod.
The reason I thought about the Ronin is do the same thing you did with the...
Hey, everybody. It's me again. I've got a $6,000 camera in my bag. I'm standing in the middle of the creek with my tripod. I just got done doing some video, long exposure stuff. I don't think that they knew that I was going to be in the creek when I said I was going to take some photos of the creek. But hopefully by the time they see this, I won't be in trouble. Why am I taking video evidence of this? I don't know. I guess we'll have it. Anyways, so. Alright. Anyways, this is the shot that I wanted to get right here. It's alright. I have lost all feeling in my legs the past 20 minutes. It's very cold in this creek. I mean, very, very cold. I have the 1DX Mark II here, safely, taking some footage in the water. It is supposed to be pretty water resistant. That's part of the perk of the 1DX. I wouldn't dunk it in there, but it should be okay if that were to happen. In the past 5 minutes, I felt a sharp pain up my legs, very sharp. I've regained feeling in my legs and it hurt. It hurt very bad. Right now I'm actually concerned that I may fall over. My legs will give out. That's a legitimate concern of mine. It wasn't until now. I hope you guys enjoyed this film. We're working hard on it. It burns. No pain, no gain, I guess, huh? Oh, wow, I almost... Okay. Alright, that's... Okay.
Overwatch the Magic Mike. We are clear for takeoff.
Alright, you are ready for takeoff.
Thank you, Magic Mike. Launching in 10, 9, land gear up 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We have ignition. We are off the ground and flying. Headed your way.
Good news, good news. We'll see you in a bit. Overwatch, thanks.
Thank you.
you. So it's gonna be broken.
Alex, what are your overall thoughts about this Inspire drone by
DJI Inspire with the X5 camera? Camera's amazing. 4K, 60 frames. No, it does 4K 30 frames. But 60 1080, it's really heavy, but the battery's big enough that you get 15 or 20 minutes of flight out of it. It's got a lot of power, but they don't let you use it all. I think to conserve battery. And it's really good overall. It connects to GPS, satellite, radar, compass. It uses everything to keep it steady. And even with like high winds, it'll automatically correct so that you'll stay level. So your shot's always good. So I love it so far. It's like 100 times better than the cheaper drones, but it also costs a million times more.
That's right, Alex. Plus, it also looks really cool. As you can see, we took a lot of inspiration from Star Wars. And if you hold it like this, you can pretend you're flying a starship. Back to you, Alex.
Thanks, Tom.
That's my professional opinion.
All right. I'm going to take it off in a minute here. I think this will be good. Yep.
I figured this spot might just work.
Fire it up. Camera recording.
This drone does come equipped with a slave secondary remote and iPad so that you can manually control the gimbal while pilot can focus on flying.
Yes.
Which is kind of cool.
It is cool. It'll be great. Let's take a little bit of practice.
Lots of practice. I can't see anything.
It's really cool.
Favorite shots. You idiot! It's been used.
Don't worry, I put worse things in my mouth. Made up with Taylor Swift. You can survive that, you can survive anything. This isn't even that smoky as her. She'd be way worse. Stuck in your teeth. Don't worry, Calvin here.
So okay. It. What? Yeah, something like that. This is our last day for our Montana trip, shooting this old Western. And I'm going to definitely miss this place and miss this view. It's absolutely unbelievable. The food here was fantastic. The dessert was made every single day. I probably gained 20 pounds. Not even gonna lie, 4 days. Definitely gonna miss the ATV rides. I did try to catch the drone as it was landing, and I hurt myself, got caught in the propeller. Sellers, don't try to do that at home, or ever, because it hurts. It'll lop your finger off if you're not careful. That'll go through bone. But yeah, so we've had a little bit of experience on the road now.
On the road again.
We're getting a little bit smarter in our travels.
Way too good.
One of our upgrades is the back bed.
Oh yeah.
It's our newest invention. Our newest renovation of this small car.
It's called the back bed. It's bed for your back.
Bed back. Bed back and beyond.
Bed back and beyond. Oh yeah.
My glasses are all scratched. I cannot see out of them.
You should really not be wearing those and driving at the same time.
But I look really cool. Oh, yeah.
For real, that's a bad idea. You cannot see through those glasses at all.
Cannot. I'm very upset. These cost me nothing. The GameStop customer left these in, and they were like, well, we don't need them anymore. So I took them, and then they got scratched. So now I lost $0. don't know if you can see it in the camera, but his whole kisser is totally chapped, wind burned, and all that jazz from the.
Oh, it looks terrible.
It's pretty gnarly.
I dipped my face in Vaseline last night. That was very nice.
Yeah, that's a regular thing, right? That wasn't even medicinal, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, everybody. It's Foster and Grayson.
And Grayson.
Are almost home to Nashville. We got really, really cool shots out in Montana. We dropped Alex off in Tulsa, Oklahoma, only adding about, I don't know, 20 extra hours off the trip.
Horrible.
Maybe 25. That's my estimation. But a lot of the shots turned out really, really well. We're really happy with them. And we also got to shoot some Destiny footage and also a concept trailer for Alex. Alex wanted to do a concept trailer, so we did that as well. Overall, I think the trip was a huge success. We have to get in there and edit it all. But Grayson, what are your thoughts?
I think everyone's going to be blown away by this. We can't, like put a whole lot out on Facebook and stuff about the store and everything just yet. It's going to be something that you'd have to go maybe see, like, Belcourt Taps, film festivals, you name it, until we can release more. But it's no one in Nashville I know is doing anything like this. This is, it's a pretty powerful story. And the shots we got, oh my gosh. This guy, unbelievable. Doesn't matter, like, what time of day it was. For 4 days, we shot 14 hours straight every day with next to no plan sometimes with what we were doing, but we managed to pull it out, and Alex did a great job with the drones. We were on cows and dust, we're tired, and these guys really pulled it out, and you're going to be amazed at what you see, and so I can't wait to show you. We all can't wait to show you. It's our best work yet.
Awesome. Check it out, guys.
Stay tuned.